Trespass by Rose Tremain. Read by Juliet Stevenson. Chapter 1. The child's name is Melody. Long ago, before Melody was born, her pretty mother had had a stab at composing music. Melody is 10 years old, and she's trying to eat a sandwich. She prizes apart the two halves of the sandwich and stares at the wet pink ham inside and at the repulsive grey-green shimmer on its surface. All around her, in the dry grass and in the parched trees, crickets and grasshoppers are making that sound they make, not with their voices. Melody has been told that they have no voices, but with their bodies, letting one part vibrate against another part. In this place, thinks Melody, everything is alive and fluttering and going from one place to another place, and she dreads to see one of these insects arrive suddenly on her sandwich or on her leg or start to tangle its limbs in her hair. Melody's hair is dark and soft. As she looks at the slimy ham, she can feel sweat beginning to seep out of her head. Sweat, she thinks, is a cold hand that tries to caress you. Sweat is something strange inside you, trying to creep from one place to another place. Melody puts the sandwich down in the dusty grass. In moments, she knows, ants will arrive and swarm round it and try to carry it away. Where she used to live, in Paris, there were no ants. But here, where her new home is, there are more ants than you could ever count. They come out of the earth and go down into it again. If you dug down, you would find them, a solid mass of them, black and red. Your spade would crunch right through them. You might not even have to dig very deep. Melody lifts her head and gazes at the leaves on the oak tree above her. These leaves are yellowing, as though it were already autumn. The wind called the Mistral keeps blowing through the tree, and the sun keeps moving and piercing the shade, and nothing in this place ever ends or is still.
Melody, says a voice, are you all right? Don't you want your sandwich?
Melody turns to her teacher, Mademoiselle Jeanne Viala, who sits on a rug on the grass a few paces away, with some of the younger children hunched up near to her, all obediently chewing their baguettes.
I'm not hungry, says Melody.
We've had a long morning, says Mademoiselle Viala. Try to eat a few mouthfuls.
Melody shakes her head. Sometimes it's difficult to speak. Sometimes you're like an insect with no voice, which just has to make a movement with some part of its anatomy. And everywhere around you, the Mistral keeps blowing and autumn leaves keep falling, even though it's a midsummer day.
Come and sit here, says Mademoiselle Viala. We'll all have a drink of water.
The teacher tells one of the boys, Jojo, one of those who tease and bully Melody and imitate her posh Parisian accent, to pass her the picnic bag. Melody gets up and moves away from the sandwich lying in the grass. And Mademoiselle Viala holds out her hand and Melody sits down there, near the teacher, whom she quite likes, but who betrayed her this morning. Yes, she did, by making her look at things she didn't want to see. Mademoiselle Viala wears a white linen blouse and blue jeans and white canvas shoes. Her arms are soft and tanned, and her lipstick is a bright, startling red. She could have come from Paris once. She takes a little bottle of Evian water out of the cumbersome bag and passes it to Melody.
There, she says. There you are.
Melody presses the cool bottle against her cheek. She sees Jojo staring at her. Bully boys' faces can be blank, absolutely blank, as though they'd never learned to say their own names.
So, says Jeanne Viala in her teacher voice, I wonder who can tell me, after the presentations we saw at the museum, how silk is made.
Melody looks away, up, sideways, far away at the jumping light, at the invisible wind. All round her, the children raise their arms, bursting to tell Mademoiselle Viala what they know, or what Melody suspects they have always known, because they're part of this landscape and were born out of its earth.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.